Well, hello everyone. Here to show you that the true celebration clearing activity right here is basically, you see right here is our hand you right here is an example. Right here is a birthday cake, and of course right here is like I say a group of like three or more people it is. And basically though, it is talk of say with the birthday cake that you talk about, it's like between when and we put our lips together, it is a blow out the candle, it is. So you'll make a birthday wish, that type of stuff it is. And knowing about that, if the person, it's like if your friends and family it is, cousins it is, who's ever there at the birthday party, if they're going to have like what you call like a blue rise, or if it's going to be like what you call is like a, maybe just put a little bit of green as well in there. I like that. Yeah, the type of tannish blue rise or brown eyes it is. But basically talking about the whole purpose about the meaning of what you call it, like, for true celebration is basically that knowing about that the main purpose about for whenever you celebrate, to say a birthday party it is, and then or it could be an anniversary it is talk about, say, the counting of the number of days it is from talking about from whenever we were born or from whenever something began it was, and knowing about that, it's still going on it is. And a lot of times that's basically what it basically means, I guess, when we celebrate is that, so far as between celebrating an anniversary or if it's celebrating a birthday, it is basically that we're celebrating the fact about that it's still present, apparently, that business, or if it's what you call, from how old that person is turning it is, of knowing about if it's a business it is talking about if it's related to any type of automobile industry, or if it's anything related to businesses or anything like that, of celebrating about from whenever the day first opened it is, from whenever the day first came to be present it was, and knowing about to celebrate about that, how long of course that they've been in business, and of course say with the birthday it is. And a lot of people probably think about that the whole meaning of say of birthdays. Now, I could tell anybody here that birthdays pretty much mean quite a bit, to me, especially whenever I was younger, because, it seemed like that back then, though, that was like the one of the times of the year to where you would be able to pick up quite a bit of the attention it was of talking about. It's like that, that was one day, of course, that whenever you're young, you may forget, of course, you may forget at times to turn in a school paper or anything like that, any type of paperwork, or forget to do your homework it is. But on our hand too, knowing about would you ever forget at a time to where whenever your birthday comes around the corner? A lot of times though, that was like, with me, hardly ever forget. Like talk about whenever my birthday was over with, a lot of times I'll be counting down for like the next year. It's like so far as knowing about with the things that maybe the presents that maybe I like to have for the next year it was. And basically though, with anybody would maybe make a birthday wish it is, blow out the candles it was, or knowing about whenever you blow out the candle that pretty much means you blow it out, it means that you turn a year older it was. And I'll starts about knowing about by looking at my own baby pictures it is, basically that if it would start out like right here, it's like a draw example right here, I say of a baby right here, and most of us will probably think about that, if we were to go ahead, if we draw details right there of a baby, but talking about that, to where that whenever we the proper ways of how to hold a baby it is to go ahead, is to whenever you pick them up, is to a lot of times with most parents would probably suggest, it's like if you're going to be picking up a baby it is to pick them up with both hands, it is, by the shoulder, it is have right here is like a baby, if it was a baby boy or a baby girl it is, all dressed up in their baby bibs it is, and like in their little outfits, as I say, with toddlers it is. But anyway, right here is like I say, example right here of a baby, and a lot of time I'm like, that you have these little, the baby can have these little fingers it is, and like talking about like time. But besides a between a baby boy and a baby girl, it is that you have these toddlers that have the, you know, these little fingers, and then knowing about that you have them dressed like right here is like, say, like a little baby bib right here, and using right here is a light green. I can maybe use a red too, but anyway, and right here is if they were sitting like this right here, with their legs, you say crossed it was, and knowing about that the yep that you have right here is a baby example right here of a baby, and from the time from whenever you were a baby it was, and then until the time that you're about maybe a year or two old, it is that a lot of times that the things that more likely that you want to play with it is, you know, such as you know any type of you know toys, Lincoln Logs, you know stuff like that, it is it more likely that you would want to play with whenever you were young it was. And a lot of times with most kids that you know toys like that, a lot of times would be stuff that more likely that they would want to play with. And so you go ahead and add a little bit of red right here, like for say for the outfit it is. I don't tell anybody here that, yeah, the parents a lot of times would buy them clothes. It is buy the kid clothes a lot of times that, you know, I don't know if they would maybe like anything. They maybe like such as a Superman, you know, shirt or anything like that. You know, Superman, a Superman outfit or anything like that. Or if anything ready to maybe the Smurfs or anything like that. But anyway, that you have right here is like, say, an example right here is like a baby outfit. And, knowing about to go ahead and add a little bit of red right here. But basically though, with any parents would probably say that, you know, the right, I guess, proper way of holding a baby it is, if you're going to pick a baby up, of course, is to, you know, use both hands, and of course, and then is to you know, gently, you know, put, you know, hold up, you know, hold it, you know, underneath the, say, the underarms, it is, you know, hold them, you know, right up you know, below the arms it is, and then gently grip them, and then lift them, and gently lift them up. It is, and a lot of times anybody probably think about it, it's like, so far as that, you know, holding the toddler, it is that whenever you, if you were to pick up a baby, it is that, you know, treat it like, you know, hold it, you know, just like if you're, you know, if you would be, you know, maybe an example would be maybe if you want to pick up a dog or a cat or anything like that of a, and, you know, talk about a baby here that that a lot of times it's like that they would probably say that you know, don't be picking him up like he's a, what you call, you know, a set of furniture or maybe the kitchen table or anything like that, maybe set of cabinets, something like that. You know, they are, you know pretty sensitive, of course, and the way you hold them, you gotta hold them properly, of course, because that way they won't feel, you know, too uncomfortable it is. But you have right here is talk about the whole meaning about, you know, true celebration, about exactly what it means, you know, from the day that you were born it was, and then from after about maybe, you know, 240 days later it is, and then knowing about that the whole part about if you were to be gathering, of course, in front, around an activity around your friends and family, and I can tell anybody here that a lot of times, though, that you know, a couple of times that whenever I could not have fun, and if I can remember a couple of times, once or twice that I would want to, you know, either if it was money problems, or if it was due to the fact because that maybe I got sick and I couldn't do too much, you say, on my birthday it was, and I can remember that always thinking about it, that, you know, why am I always the one that's getting sick, it is, and everybody else can, you know, go to the park or go have fun with their friends. If I can, and I can tell anybody here that a lot of times that, you know, on my birthday that maybe I would, you know, like to have a cake or maybe eat pizza, that, you know, the types of things that I remember doing whenever I was a kid, it was, if most of us are familiar with, like, say, it's a location such as, you know, say, Tumble Drum it is, at the, you say, Tumble Drum, and, of course, you know, there was other places, of course, like, you say, McDonald's, and it was, that, you know, went to on my birthday, it was, and, knowing about that, yeah, I would more likely to say that, you know, cost money to, of course, to put all this together, all those activities together, such as you know, getting balloons. It's like if you want to rent like a party room and have like say balloons, you know, get to have balloons all tied up, say around the ceiling, and of course a few other decorations it is. And knowing about that, with the balloons, though, that balloons more likely, I guess, would represent a number of things. That they would represent maybe, you know, how old that person was turning, or maybe the, you know, maybe their favorite color, or just like, say, what decoration it is. And I can tell anybody here that it was not on my birthday, if I can remember right. I think it was the St. Louis Zoo, whenever that had a balloon that apparently that it was filled with one of those kind of floats in the air filled with helium. But I can remember that a couple of them that if I can remember right that they got outside by accident, and then they just went and flew away. And I was like, that's my balloon. That was my balloon. But I can remember that I would get mad sometimes whenever the balloon would float away. Like, well, where'd my balloon go? But anyway, so far as knowing about with other decorations, anybody maybe think about that if they were to watch this, that knowing about that, you know, other decorations, of course, that they may have had in the past, you know, such as what you call noisemakers or anything like that, maybe dress up outfits or anything, but basically talking about the whole meeting about, they say, so far as for a celebration it is, of knowing about whenever we were to celebrate, you know, turning a year older it is, or if it's maybe a wedding anniversary it is, that a lot of times that I had the time I wondered about, it's like talking about, it's like, you know, back whenever I was 17 it was, is knowing about that, I'm trying to keep track of, you know, how old I am, you know, such and such at the time. And I was like, well, I was 16, and then next year I'll be 17, and next year I'll be 18 it is. And I kept thinking about that, 17, 18, and then somebody says, well, then so since you lived for 17 years, and I was like, well, I guess that more likely that's what that means, because I don't know if I could... what else it means, you know, such as, well, since you're 17 or 18 years old, you know, now that more likely that you know that you're qualified for 1700 points, or, you know, somebody say that, you know, you can maybe, somebody may want to give you 17 spankings, whichever it is. But so far as the counting down, I guess a lot of times that they usually say that, you know, so far as the counting down, is the older that you get, and then maybe the bigger the cake that you get, you know, whichever it is. And but knowing about that, the type of celebrations, though, that of course that we experience, say, in life, it is of knowing about, you know, maybe the one of the best times it was. And I could tell anybody here that I could probably go on stories and stories about from when I can remember. But so far as talk about, we say, what the best times it was. So far as talk about, say, what the greetings it was, that we can also say it's like a. So far as the greetings that go by, what you call is like a, you know, pleasure. It could be like what you call is like for pleasure. For something like your pleasure for, you know, knowing that. That you're, you know, as you're as old as the great recipe or something like that. The great recipe, you know, there could be other greeting cards that more likely would say something like, such as, "Hey, it's your birthday." It's like, you know, come on and celebrate or something like that. But anyway. But so far as talking about, it's like, you know, for B-Day or something like that, it's like, you know, for birthday it is. And I could tell anybody here that on my birthday one time, that I can remember, you know, going bowling, and of course, you know, doing other activities too, besides going to the movies, you know, going to the arcades. I can remember going to the arcades, I think once or twice, you say, for my birthday it was. And you know, other things, of course, that, you know, we did, you know, on our 14th birthday or on our 15th birthday, you know, list goes on. But on the other hand, too, to talk about is like more likely the list goes on so far as this the meaning about the true celebration of talking about is the birthday all about the fact about doing stuff together with your friends and family it is, or is it about the fact about that, you know, well, you know, You don't know, if I'm ever going to ever really understand about really exactly about what it means. All I know is that from the day that you were born, it was that knowing about that that you know you're not going to be qualified. You know, we're not going to give you a certain treat or anything like that. And like with anybody, they may say that that they got their own ways, of course, about how to celebrate, of knowing about your day that you were born. It was that. Talk about, see, the counting down from what you call the older that you get, and then more likely that, you know, there may be some people that may be counting down of knowing about that, by the time he's 3 years old, and then we're going to start making him do his homework, or making her do, you say, chores, like the first chore that you're going to have you do, of course, is maybe working on laundry, you know, et cetera, et cetera, it is. And with anybody that on their birthday it is that they may wish, you know, for maybe a skateboard or maybe a computer it is. And like I, you know, may mention before about that, a lot of things that, of course, that I wish for that I pretty much got them by now. But couple of things I think were like what you call, you know, to make friends. And then, of course, you know, maybe for, you know, good education, you know, stuff like that it was. And, you know, remember going go-karting, of course, on my birthday too, going bowling it was. And but the whole purpose, I guess, about the whole true manner of, say, of the celebration, which I think the whole truth is that knowing about, you say, on your birthdays, it's like, talk about, it's like for special days. The special days that they come at occasions. They come at occasions, and on the other hand, too, to think about. Certain time of the year, is to think about. The best time to look forward to. And more likely that I could tell anybody here that that's basically what it means, you know, the best time, of course, to look forward to. That, you may not be able to plan it, you know, maybe ahead of time it is, but on the hand too, that, you know, whenever we're a kid it is, and knowing about that, we may say things like, na na na, or la na na, or something like, yeah, boo boo, how you doing, or something like that, or my mommy, mommy, or dad, daddy, or something like that. At more likely, though, that I guess that's really the whole matter about, say, the truth is, like, talk about, it's like for true celebration is, talk about, you know, to look forward to, you know, certain times, say, of the year, of knowing about, from back about a year ago, it was from whenever, where you are now to where you were back then, it was, of knowing about there was only so much stuff, of course, you know, ever since maybe from the baby shower that we had for the kid, and then by the time we start getting a collection again or stuff like that, knowing about that, since the kid is now a year old, that they can go ahead and start using a bed set instead. You'll buy them a bed set, and you know, instead of the crib or, you know, anything like that. And with most of the time, though, that anybody probably think about, a lot of times that would say with most of the time mature babies, it is that they say that a lot of times, though, that. That, you know, for kids who are at least, you know, age 4 and 5, you know, are mature enough, you know, to go ahead and be able to sleep into a bed. And, you know, other than that they say that they recommend to keep them in the crib until they're at least about maybe during 38 months, about 38, 40 months, something like that, close to 2 or 3 years old it is, until they're ready to go into a crib it is, but until they're ready to go into a bed. But anyway, they talk about, it's like, you say, between a crib and a bed, huh? But other than that they have right here, it's like with the baby it is, it's like, so far as, the true celebration it is, of talking about that, for the best of time. For the best of time to remember. The day, the person the day the person came into the world. But other than that, I talk about right here, I talk about, see, the true celebrations I'm knowing about with the greetings, and of course, so far as you for true celebration, and with anybody who is like a thing, I'm like, yeah, that so far as between birthday cakes and knowing about the things about the whole matter about, about how the birthday cake tastes, or who got the biggest piece, whichever it is. And I could tell anybody here that a lot of times on my birthday, I mainly look forward to the presents. But anybody may think about, besides birthday cake and maybe games, it was that a lot of times that, if somebody were to bring a present, and I could tell anybody here that I think whenever I was young, and I don't know, I'm like, whenever I was young, I think that was the first thing that I was looking at, of course, was the presents. Besides the birthday cake, and if a lot of times I think it was the presents. And some of those presents could have been clothing products, and some of those presents could have been maybe other, types of toys it is, or maybe a new pair of shoes or anything like that, baby clothing or, something like that. But on the other hand, too, that knowing about that, with those birthday presents, anybody may have thought, I'm like, you still have those birthday presents. And I'm like, well, the TV, more likely. I'm like, I got one of the TVs that I had, ever since I was young, it was. And knowing about that, still works. That TV still works. But on the other hand, too, that like it requires, a certain type of equipment. Of course, like the converter box and stuff, just to, for it to still work. But other than that, like talk about, say, so far as the true celebration, it is of knowing about so far as the best of time, to remember, for the time that whenever you're a kid, and then talk about it, it's like to, for about, enjoying the, enjoy life. It's like, so as, as time goes on. But other than that, I talk about right here, as far as, for true celebration, collecting activity.